These are the original from Self-Rave jig. So these have been in use since 1959.
No!
A jig is basically a frame with pegs and clamps to ensure that the assembly of different panels happens the same way every single time.
So every mini then that rolled off the production line from 1959 would have come through these machines?
Yeah.
Because some people would say, when you're remanufacturing body shells, they're saying, well, you're just buying a new part.
Yeah.
But you're not, are you? Because you're buying an old new part, if you like.
Still produced off the original jigs.
Some people may even say that, you know, the soul of the car is lost. But actually, it isn't. The soul of the car is right here in this machine.
Yeah, because everyone's come off these jigs from the day one.
You think about the archives in these jigs and all the other tools and knowledge here, and the only real difference between mini bodies assembled at the old factory and the ones assembled here is the passage of time.
So I know if I come and get a mini shell, it's an original mini body shell.
Built the same process, same standards.
Brilliant. Can we see one being made?
Unfortunately, you can't. It takes about 4 days prep.
The bad news is that Martin doesn't have anything prepped for these jigs, so I can't see them in action. The good news is, well, everything else is here.
All right, nice to see your machine. Still doing its job after 60 years.
Well, this is the start of the process of building body shell. There's like a big Vulcano kit. This is Paul.
Paul, how you doing, mate?
I'm good, mate.
Very nice to meet
you.
It's loud and noisy in here, Paul, isn't it? You get used to shouting to people.
Yeah.
So Paul's going to show me how to put a wing together, is he?
Yeah.
Cool.
Components here, headlight ring, front of it. This goes round here, and you clamp that on there.
Right, now we're starting to get to bits that I sort of recognise, you know, I'm sort of recognising that's the headlamp ring for a Mini.
Yeah.
So far, I've just seen jigs and stuff. Yeah. So now we're starting to see a car actually come together. Yeah. I better get some Gucci glasses on.
Nice.
Right, lovely. So then you drop the wing on.
Over those pins there, making sure it's over the corners.
Yeah.
And another couple of clamps come on there. So.
These are great, these machines, aren't they? This would be exactly the same process they would have done back in 1959 originally, when they first started to put the Mini together.
These are the same guns.
Same guns, same
jigs.
Really? It's just brilliant. Yeah, I don't think you're very keen on letting me have a go, Paul, are you?
You can have a go.
Really? Do you know what? It's something. There's going to be something really good about this.
Yeah.
The fact that I've had a hand in spot welding, you'll have to tell me where to put it.
Spot welding joins two pieces of metal together using the heat from an electric current. No filler or open flame needed.
Lovely.
It's fast and efficient, but the individual welds are weak, which is why Paul and I are putting in a fair few.
We don't want to weld my family jewels to the bench. Where? There. That is absolutely fantastic. So now you release it.
Release it.
Somebody out there in the world is going to get a wing on their little Mini, knowing full well that I've done the welding on it.
I can almost close my eyes and imagine it's 1959 and I'm working at the old Morris Motors factory. I think I might have been happy doing that.
Lovely. How cool was that, Paul?
Yeah, well done.
That was really good.
Do you ever want a job?
I just want to build some more now.
So what we're seeing now is the front end being put together.
Right, so...
So your wing you manufactured?
So my wing I manufactured is on that side. So this is now the marrying of this front end onto this firewall.
Yeah.
Here. Yeah. And then where do they go after this? What's the next place?
Goes round to the main jig.
Should we have a look?
Yeah.
British Motor Heritage produces 50 to 60 mini bodies a year, along with orders for MGs and other British cars. That may not sound like much compared to Ford selling 700,000 pickups last year, but every shell has decades of experience and care put into it. These are handmade cars for a speciality market. Most go into people whose vintage minis are in good working order but have significant body damage or rust problems.
So this is when a whole lot gets married together? Yeah,
definitely. So you've got the front end, you've got the rear end.
It's nice to see it so exposed and naked. You see the spare wheel well there. That's where you put your battery, look. That's the rear seat. Front seat. This is on this chain because it's going to come onto this jig.
Yeah.
And then that front end,
yeah,
that comes up, and this is where the whole lot gets married together.
Definitely, yeah.
And the roof goes on?
Yeah.
And so the side panels?
All the side panels, the whole car is
manufactured. Oh, really? The whole thing's assembled here?
Yeah.
Wow. Do we get to see it coming on?
Yeah, we will do. And then they'll locate on the front.
Very good. How many cars are you manufacturing at any one time here?
Currently in this build, we've got 42 going through, which is one of the biggest we've ever done. The car will be completed on this, and then go on to different types of roof roller welded, and
right,
then gets moved through to the finishing booth to be finished off with the doors, boot, bonnet.
Great, isn't it?
Yeah.
What can you do to improve the old Mini? Or are you doing anything to improve it?
We're not doing anything to improve it. It's to the original specification. The only difference is it's premium automotive steel. So we only buy the steel when we need it. We don't bulk buy. That is the only improvement.
Right, so when the steel comes in, it's fresh?
It's all fresh, yeah.
I could stand here all day and watch this. It's lovely.
Yeah.
It is lovely. It's real engineering.
Always
I love it. I love it. It is brilliant.
It's remarkable how quickly the car starts to come together. These guys are incredibly skilled at this.
There you go. Smoking, look. Excellent work. And they can build one of these shells in a day.
Well, if everything's built, all the sub-assemblies, yeah, they can get it all through.
Lovely. The roof's coming in now. I think this will be a big moment when it actually becomes a car.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The delicate hand of a...
Yeah, that's what you need. It's a bit of brute force, isn't it? But
all they'll do now is they'll just... They'll plant it in place, make sure the structure of the car's equal either side, and then it'll spot weld, then they'll take it over there and they'll do a roller weld all the way around.
All the way round, yeah.
But actually now, just make sure the actual windscreen is in the right position, so that will suddenly we'll see it pop up a little bit.
How cool is that? So that's the exact
measurement. So that's to make sure the windscreen... So there's normally a metal piece in there to make sure it's there, so that gets cut off. So now the roof, the whole windscreen is in the right place to be able to get...
Do you do that on the back as well? Or do you
just on the front. So you see the gun's got a special tip on it, so
yeah,
it can go inside the weld.
It's a flat tip, so you can go inside the roof gully and he can clamp it down and spot weld it inside the roof gully.
So is this what you thought it would be like?
I was hoping it would be like this, yeah. Yeah, really industrial. I've been in lots of factories and it's all robots and computers. Yeah. You don't see anything.
Yeah. This is such a bit like the heart and soul of...
Yeah, it is. A Mini.
Yeah.
It went from being panels to now it's a car.
A Mini shell,
It's a Mini. So what happens to it now?
Now they'll go over and then have the roller weld around the roof, down the seam, to make sure all the seams are structurally sound.
Well, the car's DNA is what the valuable part of the car is. But what we're saying, and what these guys are doing here, if you start cutting a car apart because it's got rust in it, like the floor, and then you're going to do the firewall, you're going to do the inner wings, then why not just replace the whole thing and have a brand new car to begin with? It's still the same car, it's just you're replacing it with new parts. You know how many... I bought Minis and I've replaced the floors in Minis, I've replaced inner wings in Minis. But I wish I could have done all of it, you know, and that's what's happening here. A lot of people like me, you know, I'm a huge Mini fan, massive Mini freak. I'm going to go back to that soul question again.
Yeah.
Because the Mini is a car that has got a character, quite possibly one of the most iconic historic cars ever, like a Model T, like a Jaguar E-Type, a Volkswagen Beetle. Yeah. They are the most iconic cars ever. The soul of the Mini is in this factory? Do you feel that when you bought these machines into this building, you bought the soul of the Mini with it?
Yeah, and all its history and all its glory. Yeah, look, every Mini's been built off these jigs, and to be able to keep continue building that soul into these cars is amazing.